Okay, great. So welcome all. Welcome to Financial Fitness. My name is Sameer Bapat. And today we are going to learn. We all know that FIIs are selling big time. So what is the opportunity for us to buy? Which shares we should buy? And corrections like this gives us clear winners of future. So this is a great opportunity to get ready and to find a technique, to find winners for the future. So let's get started. Before we start, I would like to thank you all for your time. I know you have a busy life with office opening up, lots of things to do, but still you chose to be here. I'll make sure it is well worth your time. So let's deep dive into analyzing the stocks, which may be potential winners of coming future and coming year in 2022. So this is the background. This is our starting point. So this is our thought process. I'll be sharing the entire thought process with you, how we are going about it. So as we are all aware, if you are not aware, take it as a information that FII has sold shares in the cash market worth 30,000 crore from October till date. This is the data available on Google or Money Control, anywhere you can get it. They have sold stocks worth 30,000 crore. That's why we are seeing a downfall since October 20th, almost October 20th. They have been selling and the market's indices, Nifty, Bank Nifty, has been going down since. We have DII data also, so DII are buying, but they will not take up everything, whatever they are giving. So maybe it is distributed somewhere else. So DIIs are our direct institutional investors, Indian investors who are buying from the FIIs. So this is how the balance is going on. Yet, maybe they are also not buying so aggressively. So the markets are going down. This creates a very important opportunity for us to select the stocks. Now to build the analogy or the analysis point of view, which I am coming to you in this webinar, to build that, I would like to take an example of our common observation nearby us. So I would like to ask you one thing. You must have seen people like living nearby you or your friends or someone or in your apartment. Nowadays, they have a common WhatsApp group for apartment also. So if a person is moving out of his house, if he's getting transferred to some other city, and then normally people will, if they are leaving, they will try to dispose of whatever is they are not willing to carry. Have you experienced this? Have you come across this situation? Can I have yes? If you have seen people or heard about or have seen a post, okay, I'm leaving my apartment, I'm going back to India, or I'm going to Bombay, I'm going to Bangalore, blah, blah, blah. And these all items I am selling out or giving out. Right, this is what people do. Normally, this is what is there. Now, if someone is leaving, even if it's going from one city to another city, normally we sell it off to avoid the hassle. If I take it from here to there, I may have this problem, that problem. So rather I sell it off here and I will go. But even if you are going, there will be some items which people will not sell. They will rather take it with themselves to the next city also. Those are the valuable items for them. In spite of hassles, they are inclined to take it. Do you agree that in spite of hassle of shifting or moving, still some valuable those people will keep with them? How many of you agree? Can I have yes? If people will keep some valuables with them to take, so they will not sell it off and go. Now, what is being sold, out of that also, people will see value for money. Okay, if he's selling a sofa set, okay, is it of wood, made of wood, old wood? People will say, acha, value for money is going. let's buy it, right? So it's a value for money. So it will be lasting for this thing. And whatever is not valuable or not very important will be given away free of cost. So that is how it works. Agreed? So this is the process, right? If someone is moving, someone is selling out, he will keep something valuable with him. He will put on sale whatever is they think can be given out. And whatever they are putting on sale, whatever is more valuable will be picked up. Less valuable may or may not be picked up, and the price will go down. It will go down and all. How many of you agree with this logic? Because this is our base logic for whatever we are going to find today, stocks we are going to find today. Yes, can I have a yes from all of you if you agree with this logic? This is how it works, right? When we are shifting out. Now, going forward, let's say FIIs are selling out big time. Yes, they are selling out whatever be the reason. We will not go into the reasons why they are selling, why they are exiting. It happens. They book their profits because of the requirement of their shareholders. But still, in spite of what they are selling out, they will be keeping good stocks in spite of all hassles. If they find that, okay, I have portfolio for this many stocks, but they will selectively at least keep those stocks with them which they find value for the future, and they will dispose of which they can give away. Okay, there are not much growth for the share price is left, so they might give away those shares, sell those shares, but they will still sort of keep shares with them which they will have value for the future. Second of all, then if they are selling, who are the buyers? DIR are the buyers. DII will also not buy everything. Okay, you are selling, give it to me. They also will have their own analysis team, and they will be picking and buying stocks which they find, whatever is FII are selling, out of that, if they find the value, then only they will buy. Anyway, if they are selling, let it go down. If it has a lesser value, we'll buy later, we'll see. But at least right now, pick up the good valued stock. So DII also will buy only in those shares which are having a potential out of what is being sold, and remaining stocks will have a downfall. So that is how will happen also in shares. Good will be retained by FIIs and DIIs both. DIIs will pick up what FII are selling. They find the analysis is good, and remaining will have its own natural fall due to gravity. Now, stocks which are attractive to FII and DII both will not have gone much from the high. Now, this is the point, right? So it's okay. Theory is okay. Everything is okay. Now for us, if we want to know which stocks are those stocks which have not gone down, which have not gone down from the high, which are been retained by FII and DII both. So how many of you agree that if they are selling and if the stock is no one is buying, like no one is willing to buy too much, the price will go down? How many of you agree that if no one is willing to buy much, that gradually because of the gravity itself, the price will go down? Agree? So other way around is also correct, right? If they are not willing to sell the stocks, then the price will not slide down. Correct. So the sliding, if they are not willing to sell, the slide of emotionally the stock price may go down because overall market it is going down. So emotionally, because of the overall trend, few stocks will go down, but there is likelihood that the price will not slide. It will not go down so much. So this is our filtration criteria number one. Stocks which are attractive to FII and DII both are less likely to fall as compared to other stocks. That is the principle number one. Principle number two is stocks which are attractive to DII also would have not gone down. So this we have established. Then how to find? We are going to use two techniques for finding these good stocks. First of all, since we are in December and shareholding pattern, I'll explain later, this changes after every quarter. So we cannot use the technique number two as of now, but I will give you idea which you can use same in the January month. Today, in today's webinar and for immediate requirement, we will be checking the value from 52-week high value. So let's deep dive. If you are ready to learn this method, type yes. Can I have yes from all of you if you are ready to learn this technique, how we are finding? Yes? Okay, great. So just give me 1 minute. Okay. Now, so as you can see, this is the chart of Nifty. And as you can see, the stock Nifty index, the Nifty 50 index has started going down from this point, October 19th onwards. It has started going down. And as of now, from its 52-week high, if we measure it, how far it has gone down, as of lowest it has touched is around 12%. So from peak, the stock, the indices, not the stock, overall stock market, if you say, and Nifty being the indicator for stock market, it has gone down by 11%. So the entire indices has gone down by 11%, which is Nifty. If you see how much Bank Nifty has gone down, Bank Nifty from its peak in October, it has gone down by almost 18%. So Bank Nifty, which is again a very strong indicator, banks are very strong indicators of economy. Nifty is a general indication of economy. So Nifty has gone down by 11%. Bank Nifty has gone down by 18%. So we'll take Nifty as our benchmark. So what we have to do is, we have to go to Screener. I hope everyone has created a free account in screener.in. If you have not created, create a free account in screener.in. It's a fantastic site. You have to, like, just a minute, someone has drawn some line. Okay. Okay. Everyone has this website, Screener. Screener.in, you have login ID, user ID, password in this website. Yes? Okay, great. So what you have to do is you have to go to screens. Once you log in, just go to screens and you go to create new screen. Click on this, you'll get this window. You can do it. I'll upload the video. You can see peacefully. Now, what we are doing is our benchmark is Nifty. That is index, how far index has gone down. It has gone down by 11% from top to bottom. And this is what is 52-week high, right? In last 1 year, the indices was how high it went. And this point is 52-week high. In last 1 year, how high it has gone? This is a 52-week high. So what our parameter is, we'll type high. See, beauty of this website is you will get lots of filter, technical and fundamental together. Technical are less, more of fundamental. It is already giving us a prompt down from 52-week high. So select that. Down from 52-week high is less than or equal to 11%, because Nifty went down by 11%. We are taking it as a benchmark. So let's run this query. Out of 4,000 stocks, 797 stocks have gone down by 11% or less. Second thing, we are interested in what is being held by FII and DII. So we type A and D. FII holding is greater than zero and DII holding is greater than zero. Now let's run the query and we get 128 results. Just for people who are new to Screener, you can click on this. If you go down, scroll down, you click on any data, you scroll down. Here you will find the shareholding pattern. Who is having the shares of this company? As you can see, which is this company? Nestle India. In Nestle India, the promoters, the people who have formed the company are, as of September 2021, they are holding 62.76% of shares in this company. FIIs are holding 12.31, DIIs are holding 7.99, and general public like you and me, we are having 16.93% of shares. What we are doing in our query is we are finding the shares which have not gone down less, which have from its 52 week high, it has not gone down much and are having holding by FII and DII both. But the problem is the data what we are getting is as of September 2021. Okay, so now the latest holding by FII and DII will be available in January after the December, because every quarter the companies will declare who are their shareholding holders in their company, who are still holding their shares, who have come out. So this is a September data, but this is our starting point to know which have gone, which companies have gone or fallen down lesser, and we can focus in December, January, once we get the data where the FIIs have sold and where they have DII have purchased. So we have to, everyone clear? So far so good? Can I have yes? If the, where we are looking at data, what is the shareholding pattern? Yes? Okay. Okay, Gopal Krishnan, it is not clear. Shareholding pattern. We are looking at the shareholding pattern. As you can see on my screen, in Screener, I am not able to get it converted to Excel sheet as you had told earlier. Also, no, wait, I think sheet you will get in paid version only. Okay, Pankaj, you will not get in free version. I am also using free version. Okay, so now, okay, so these are the shareholding patterns of FII and DII. Now, what we have done is, company share value. Okay, so I got the, so what we are doing is, we are down from 52 week high. Okay. So just for example, this first query, what I am trying to find is, let me take EKI. EKI, as you can see, has in fact gone up, right? In spite of the market falling since October, EKI has gone up, correct? Agreed? So it has not gone down. EKI has not gone down. Similarly, let's say, just a minute, let me find one. Just a minute, give me 1 minute, please. Okay. Now, second is one more example I can give is So this is one stock which has not gone down since October, as we can see, it is on the higher side. Okay, it is on higher side. Correct. So even from the peak, it had the peak reached only 3 days ago. It has not gone down. We have one Infosys here. So Infosys Limited, if you see, it has not gone down. It is still near the peak. So we want to find out the stocks which have not gone down. That is point number one. So that is the query number one. We are writing down from 52 week high less than 11. We can even change it to 10. So they are less than 11 or 10. That is point number one. Second is, since we are looking from the point of view of FII and DII high, the second query is FII holding is greater than zero. Third query is DII holding is greater than zero, means they are having some hold stake in that share. Once we run this query, we will have 109 shares. Okay. Okay, so one clarification. That's what I tried to clarify. Holding, Rahul has asked, holding pattern is also an indicator. They are not sold of the shares. Okay. Now that is the caution. When we are running this query, this 109 results which are coming, they are having two results. One is they are FII had invested. But as I said, we will not have the latest data as of December. Okay, please note everyone, this shareholding pattern data is as of September 2021. It is not as per December 2021, because December data we will get in January and only when it is published by the companies. Okay, so don't take this data as the final data. This is how I'm teaching you to analyze and shortlist. Later on, you can have a data from here, January and all you can have. And then you have to compare. In January, you have to run the query again. I'll share the query in the group. Or you can see the YouTube video for the query. Okay. So you have this. Then what we do is basically, how much you want minimum to earn from stock market? That is my criteria. Normally, this is a question, how much returns minimum you want? I know maximum is 100% returns yearly. That is not possible. But what is the minimum everyone expects? Can I say 15% we expect from the company? If you are expecting 15% CAGR minimum, then the company should also be growing with 15% CAGR. So we put in some more filtration criteria, like return on ROCE, okay? ROCE greater than 15 and ROE, return on equity greater than 15 and profit growth greater than 15, everything will keep 15. Okay, growth 3 years, let's say. Growth 3 years greater than 15 and sales growth 3 years greater than 15. Okay, I'll take one more and pledged percentage equal to zero. Okay. And let's run the query. And we have 7 companies. Okay. Can you see the 7 companies in front of us? Yes, no? So if you want, we can relax. You can relax your parameters. I'll give you this parameters. You can relax this parameters also if you want little more. But if you go and see the chart, let's see one by one. EKI, okay? EKI, okay, Energy Services System. It is going higher and higher. Looks good. Someone is investing. Then Tanla Platforms. Okay, just barely down. It is an uptrend, right? So once all this falling down of stock market will fall, stop, what will happen? Let's say third is Apollo Tricot. Let's see what is happening to Apollo Tricot. Apollo. Okay, so here they are, like almost consolidation and ready to go up. Then we are having L&T Infotech, okay. Infotech, where is it? Infotech. Now, here it is. APL Apollo Tubes, APL Apollo Tubes, APL. Okay, see, again, it is in uptrend. In spite of market going down, all these company shares are almost on a uptrend. Then, I don't know which company is this, Butterfly, Gamap, okay, Everest Kanto. Let's see what is this Everest Kanto. Kanto Cylinders, okay, see, this is again on uptrend. So, how many of you agree with this simple query? Okay, Butterfly, someone knows Butterfly. So let's see Butterfly, Butterfly General Labs. Butterfly, this one. Huh? Okay, they are also in uptrend. How many of you agree that with simple logic, we are able to identify at least 7 stocks which are already in uptrend or already on the verge of breakout once the market starts going up? Do you agree that these are the stocks which will push up because they have not gone down? They refuse to go down. That means someone is keeping that. Someone is buying them. Someone is making sure that they have that in their portfolio. Even if the markets are going down, they have kept these stocks in their portfolio or bought or accumulated something. How many of you think that once the market settles down or it starts turning around, once the negative sentiment goes away, these are the stocks? I'm not saying these are the only stocks or these are the stocks, but how many of you think these are highly probable stocks that will go up? That will go up. How many of you agree? Can I have yes, if you agree that there is a likelihood that they will go up? And how many of you agree that if we have a simple logic and a simple situation and a simple analysis and a great site like Screener, okay, I'm not a salesperson for Screener, huh? Okay, I'm using it for 11 years, that's why I'm saying, but a fantastic site like Screener, simple logic can give us good shares which we can invest. As soon as market turns around, we don't have to pray, oh God, let it go up. No. They are good companies, they'll go up. You can further fine tune, okay? You can further remove some more parameters and take, but immediately you are good to go and it will likely to go up. Yes? Great. So this is one thing. Second thing is, I'll just copy paste the query here also in the group. Please don't type anything. If you want, you can copy this query and use in Screener. I'm typing it in the chat box. I have pasted in the chat box. I'll give you 2 minutes. Just copy the query and you can use in Screener. You don't have to do anything. Straight away, copy it. No, wait. We don't type anything. Please don't type anyone. Don't type anything. Just copy. Let everyone copy this query from the chat. I have pasted it in the chat. Okay. Now, what you have to do is, this is one. Okay. This is one good technique. Second, what I'm suggesting, I'm not saying, once you have done this, again, revisit this video if you want, if you have any doubt, but this is the technique what you have to do in around January end. By January end, you will have, let's say if we are opening this butterfly company and if we go down, we are seeing the shareholding pattern. FIIs are holding 0.68, DIIs are holding 9.7, common public 25% and 64%. Now, these stocks you can start observing, monitoring the stocks. But one more suggestion which is applicable in January, because the data of shareholding pattern is only till September 2021. If you want to fine tune and if you want to hit the more precision, in more precision, January end, what you do is you add two more things in the entire query. You write and this is the beauty of Screener. They have given a fantastic screening criteria. We have FII, change in FII holding, they have given, right? This is change of FII holding. If you run as compared to December and September, you will come to know what they have sold off in this quarter. Okay. FII change in FII holding is greater than or equal to zero. You do it and change in DII holding greater than equal to zero. Add these two lines sometime in January and run this query. This is for September compared to earlier. So, okay, this may or may not be reflecting. But if you want to do it in January, you will get the exact picture. What was sold off by FII? What was bought by DII? Or if you want to know what was unchanged or done any changes in FII, run this query in the month of January end, around January end, and you will have a much better picture of what happened during October to December, what was sold off, what was retained, what was acquired, what changed the hand from strong hands to strong hands, what all stocks were left alone and let to fall down. It is better not to touch stocks which were not even looked upon by. It's only a suggestion, okay? It's not a rule. You can go with that. So I have pasted the query which you have to run in January end. So in January end, you can run this query and see what shares have changed the hand. If it is coming out of the query, you can let it go. Fine. Okay, so copy the query. I'll give you 2 minutes and you can copy the query. You can go to TradingView and have a look. Okay, great. So with that, we come to the end of the session today. It is a very short session. And this will be the last session for the year 2021 because many of us are going on leave, holidays. Are coming year-end holidays. So now the webinar will restart the webinars from the first week of January. Okay. So if you have, I hope, can I have, yes, if you have enjoyed the session today, if you have enjoyed, type E if you have enjoyed the session today and you learned a lot of interesting things today. Okay, great. Thank you. Thank you so much. I will take up the questions. I hope people have enjoyed in the entire 2021. I think I conducted almost 100 sessions in this year 2021. And I thank you so much for everyone, each and everyone, for joining the webinars in 2021. We'll be continuing the same in 2022. Also, so I think 2021, I conducted almost 100 plus webinars. And we'll be continuing the same with the same zeal, more zeal in 2022. And great. If you have any questions, you can post in the group, right? So I'll upload this entire video on the YouTube. You can go through on it on YouTube and all. You can share with your friends. So thank you. Thank you so much. I'm not taking questions today. Sorry for that. But thanks a lot. Thank you so much for joining. I wish you all a happy new year. See you in new year, first week, January 2022. Thank you. Thank you. And happy Christmas to all of you.